currently, when you use Listerine or any other general antimicrobials, it's like you use a general herbicide. At this point, we discover more than 1,000 different kind of bacteria species. Most of them are good bacteria, few of them are bad. The best analogy I've been using is the weeds versus grass. And what this particular technology, what we call STAMPS, because it's a specific targeted antimicrobial peptide. And what it does, it's like acting like a smart bomb. It goes to the mixture, only kill the weeds, leave the grass intact.
This whole novel mouth rinse idea came about from a very interesting microbiological problem, which is in the mouth you have all these thousands of different types of bacteria, but you know, less than half a dozen, arguably maybe even just one major pathogen, cause cavities. So with that framework behind the idea of, well, there's our main target, if we can eliminate that target without killing the rest of the bacteria, that idea of preserving the normal flora and establishing them as a protective force in oral care is something that's never been explored before.
FDA has officially approved our investigative new drug application.
So we're excited because it will be going into its phase one clinical trials, and we're looking to have about 36 subjects enrolled in this study. It will be looking both at safety and initial efficacy.
We patented by the UCLA. We moved the technology out and opened the company right next to UCLA. Majority of employees are UCLA graduates, and we're developing that in California and try to improve the California technology. So it's really about, you know, the true value of the intellectual property we're creating in the university could actually benefit the real world and through this kind of experience.
The impact on dentists and dental practice in general will be positive. This represents not a replacement for the current status of care that dentists employ. This is another tool that they can use, and it will provide them another way to manage the disease process. And so it gives them more options, and it really can enable them to take a more, almost an anti-effective, infective approach to dental practice rather than a surgical approach. And it just gives them another weapon to fight against dental caries. So I think it's a very positive development for dental practice.